All right, Carlos. We're not too focused on the water heater right now. That's 75-gallon A.O. Smith. We're focusing our attention on this Weil-McLain. I'm going to guess it's a CGA 5. That's the model number of it. You're going to notice that it has multiple zones on the right-hand side. We have three circulators. We have stainless steel vent, steel vent piping going into a chimney with the draft diverter. Mm-hmm. Unlike the one that we saw, the New Yorker boiler, which was a power vented boiler, it doesn't use a chimney. This utilizes a chimney, which is also connected to the water heater.
Right.
Pretty clean install, would you say?
Yeah, it looks good.
Okay, we installed this in 2023, March 16th. Wow, March 16th, 2020 was when COVID shut down the world. So about March 16th, 2023, so a little over 2 years, approaching 3 years was the install. And the last tune-up was in 2024, according to this. And today we're going to do a tune-up. It's fairly clean, but I'm going to show you step-by-step what we do so you can know for future reference. You ready?
Yep.
We're going to turn off power. The power's off. You don't gotta touch anything else. The power's off, you're
just
good.
Just a switch.
Okay. And as long as it turns the power off, you're good. That turned off, so we're good. We're gonna remove the combustion cover.
Screws.
Yeah, they're a little tight there. And this is why I normally bring in my tool bag, but I got my little Leatherman, and we should be all right. Well, I got one too. Let's see if I can loosen up that screw. If not, see what I get for being lazy? I can't even get in there.
I thought about buying the titanium version, but it was overkill.
Yeah, and now I wish I had.
They don't make it anymore.
Nope. No bueno. Alright, so here are all the burners.
These. That's not my stuff.
Just crap. So we will take these out. And one thing I love about the Weil-McLain is that I do not need to lay on the floor to put them back in there. They go back in peacefully. Mm-hmm. Now you'll notice that they all are pretty fairly clean. Just a little bit of white debris. Mm-hmm. And that is unusual. I don't normally see that. But that's probably going to be the ceramic, you know, shell, the coating that's inside there.
That's
which...
Cool.
Yeah, it looks fine though.
Like the insulation.
Yeah, all right. Let's get our vacuum ready. Mm-hmm. We will vacuum out the combustion chamber. Get over there. And just make sure the battery is good. We have 3 bars in the battery. A lot of lint I'm noticing in here as well. We may want to check the dryer vent and make sure that that is intact, that nothing is broken, separated. Let's see, because the laundry is right behind us, but we don't want to clean the problem, but not make the problem go away. Combustion chamber is clean. All right, and since all the burner slats are clean, we can blow through them. Good. All of our burner tubes are good. So what we're gonna do, good. We are going to lubricate these burners. There you go. And I like to take like a rag, it's a well-oiled rag, and just give it a nice little wipe. And we put these back in the burner, inside the combustion. All right, all the burners are back in place. The combustion plate is back in place. And we make sure that the wiring for the rollout switch is not like touching anything metal, because it will eventually burn through the insulation and short something out and you'll blow the transformer. Pretty straightforward, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. This is the boiler control. Mm-hmm. It has a temperature dial on it. It also has an economy adjust dial. The temperature should be 180 and the economy adjust should be in the middle. Okay. This is the gas valve. This is an intermittent pilot gas valve, and it, instead of two wires and a thermocouple, it has three wires and just a pilot tubing going to the pilot. Okay. MV is main valve, MVPV, main valve, pilot valve, and then PV is pilot valve. So when there's a call for heat, main valve gets power first. Sorry, take that back. Pilot valve gets energized.
Right.
It sends gas to the pilot burner. The box sends that spark, it ignites, it senses that flame, mm-hmm. and then opens up MV and send voltage to MV. Make sense?
Mm-hmm.
All right. The top goes on first. Slide the top, slide it up. Push it down. Okay. Now, on all of the boilers that we work on, you are going to, and if it's an atmospheric boiler, you have some kind of diverter, whether it's built into the front of the boiler or it's a donut bell looking thing like it is here, right? If it's like this, you're going to see a hole drilled in the flue piping approximately 6 inches off the top of the boiler, right? Before the diverter. Mm-hmm. If the diverter is built into the front of the boiler, you're not going to do this. Mm-hmm. You need to shove the probe inside the boiler.
Okay.
I think we did a steam boiler like that.
Yes.
Okay. Behind the boiler, remember we rested on top of it.
Yeah.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Three zones, circulated ice and flange before, circulated ice and flange with purge above.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Turn the switch on. Green light is on. No zones are actively calling right now. Let's find the nearest thermostat and turn it on.
You all right?
Yeah. You turned on two thermostats.
Yes.
Yes. Remember to turn on the closest thermostat?
Yeah, I was. Yeah. I didn't see it.
Okay. There's a reason I do. There's a reason for everything I say typically, mm-hmm. right? Because if you turn on one thermostat, mm-hmm. you're going to know what thermostat that is and what area of the house that controls. Now you have two zones on, and you want to make sure every zone is working independently. So go turn off one of those thermostats, and remember which one is still on, and we will check the heat in that particular zone. Makes sense, right? I'm not trying to be a hard ass, but a good technician is observant of his surroundings. By turning on multiple thermostats, you're unable to test zone by zone. All right, zone two is running still. This pipe is lukewarm. This is hot. This is also lukewarm. So zone two is this middle circulator leaving. Return, cold, blazing hot. Cold. So since those are circulators located on our supply, we are circulating water from supply to return, proving circulation to the zone. We just turned off zone number two thermostat. We're going to turn on zone number one and check for circulation on the circulator supply and then eventually the return. We know the one in the middle is going to be hot because we just had that one on. So is it the...
three.
So the last one?
Yeah, this one.
Lukewarm?
Nah, just temperature.
Okay. So we know that zone one you just turned on is the furthest circulator on the right.
Mm-hmm.
And now feel the pipe on the left and the pipe on the right. One should feel like colder than it was before. Just grab both of them with your hands. Not the one in the middle, one on the left and one on the right. You already know the one in the middle is zone two. If you keep your hands on it, which one feels like it's getting cold and then getting hotter?
They're about the same, really.
Okay, then keep your hands on there. You'll feel it, feel the difference. The pipe on the left, the pipe on the right. It's not going to burn you because you're not touching the one in the middle. That is the return piping. So ambient temperature water is making its way back to the boiler because the circulator is pushing the water or circulating water through that zone. So is it the one on the left or one on the right?
This one.
Is it that one getting hot?
Yeah.
Yep.
This one.
Stop feeling the one in the middle. You already did that one. You know that's zone number two. We want to determine whether the left or the right pipe is the return for...
Same.
Okay, so the one on the right is the return for the zone you just turned on. And if you follow that pipe, that the one that's getting hot in the return, follow that pipe. It goes to this air handler right here, which just kicked on because it sensed the hot water going through the fan coil. Make sense?
Yep.
Okay, so you just proved zone 2 works, zone 1 works. Now we gotta turn zone 3 on and make sure that works as well. All right, so zone 1 is still on. Carlos is turning off the thermostat, but our temperature hit, it's 179, but hit that set point of 180. When zone 1 is now off, he's gonna turn on zone 3. We're gonna circulate water through zone 3, and we're gonna have to quickly do a combustion test to prove how the system is burning fuel on today's date at this time. All right, Carlos, grab the combustion analyzer, press start on draft analysis. You should read ambient temperature reading. You have to move quick because that fires up and gets the temperature fast. So just press start. What's our ambient temperature?
60, 70, basically.
You didn't press start yet. I don't hear it running. Okay. What's our O2 at? 21%?
20.8.
Okay, very good. And as soon as that boiler fires up, you want to get that probe in that hole that was drilled in the flue piping.
You want to leave it in the middle, right?
And you want it in the middle of that flue piping, right? And you're going to have to do this quick. Now, the boiler's already at temperature, so it's only going to take seconds for you to get a good reading. You should be at around in the high 300 degree mark with the temperature. And we'll see what it is. As soon as the boiler turns off, or as soon as you're confident with the numbers, you're going to hit that clipboard button, which is the button all the way on the top right. Clipboard button.
Not
the print button, clipboard button. Because you will copy the results to the clipboard of what's there, and that way you can do the next test. We're at 164, 163, 162, 160. It's dropping. That zone is on, and the boiler's getting cold water. And it just, you can put it in there now if you want. The vent damper is opening. There you go. You hold that there. Perfect. Well, yeah, whatever. That's good, too. And once that fires up, we're going to get some numbers there. You're going to ready to see your temperature probably increase already, 120. But that O2 is not going to change because there's no exhaust gases going.